वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, श्री श्याम इंटरनेशनल स्कूल की ऑनलाइन कक्षाओं में आप सभी का स्वागत है। टुडे आई वांट टू टीच यू द टॉपिक लॉस्ट चाइल्ड फ्रॉम द बुक मोमेंट्स। This is the first lesson of the book Moments, and the students who have old books. In old books, this is fifth chapter, Lost Child. Lost Child is a story of a child who goes to visit a fair with his parents. The crowd of the villagers was going towards the fair. The child was also going to visit the fair with his parents. On the way, the child attracts towards many things because it was his first chance. He was attracted by the beauty of the nature, and that is why he was lingering behind. His parents were calling him again and again to walk fast, to accompany them. On the way, they passed through green fields, green mustard fields, and ultimately they reached to the fair. It was a very crowded place. There were many shops of sweets and toys. The boy wanted to buy toys, sweets, but he was familiar with the refusal nature of his father, of his parents. Ultimately, the boy goes to a crowded place in the fair. There was a great rush around a merry-go-round. He wanted to take a joy ride on the swing, and at that place, unfortunately, he loses his parents. Here, the story turns a new round. The boy's attitude towards the things ultimately changes when he loses his parents. He cries for his parents. A gentleman picks him up and he takes him round to the fair. He offers him sweets, toys, but in the end of the story, the boy refuses to accept anything. He only wants his parents. His attitude totally changes. The moral of the story is that we are all lost children in this world. We all have interest in the outward beauty outward world. Just as in the beginning of the story, the boy was interested in all around sceneries. He wanted to buy many things, but when he lost his parents, he only wanted to meet them. He wanted nothing else. So today, I want to teach you this story, and I hope that all of you will listen me, write your lesson, learn your lesson, learn the meaning properly. The lost child. It was the festival of spring. From the wintry shades of narrow lanes and alleys emerged a gaily clad humanity. Gaily clad humanity means people wearing fancy dresses were going towards the fair. Some walked, some rode on horses, others sat, being carried in bamboo and bullock carts. One little boy ran between his father's legs, brimming over with life and laughter. The crowd of the people was going toward the fair. People were in fancy dresses. Some were walking, some were riding the horses and bullock carts, and the boy was walking with his parents, and he was in jolly mood at that time. "Come, child, come," called his parents as he lagged behind. As the child was lingering behind, his parents told him to hurry up, fascinated by the toys in the shops that lined in the way. Why was the boy lingering behind? Because he was fascinated by the toys shop that lined in the way. He hurried towards his parents, his feet obedient to their call, his eyes still lingering in the receding toys. Although he was walking with his parents, but still his eyesight was lingering towards the toys. As he came to where they had stopped to wait for him, he could not suppress the desire of his heart, even though he well knew that old cold stare of refusal in their eyes. When the boy came to his parents, at that time he was also looking towards the toys, although he knew very well. He was well familiar with the habits of his parents. He knew very well that they would surely refuse him. They would not buy him any toys or sweets. "I want that toy," he pleaded. Pleaded means requested. His father looked at him red-eyed in his familiar tyrant way. Tyrant means बहुत ही अत्याचारी तरीका, क्रूर तरीके से उसके पिता ने बच्चे की तरफ देखा. दैट वॉज हिज फेमिलियर वे. वो उसका जाना माना एक तरीका था. हिज मदर मेल्टेड बाई द फ्री स्पिरिट ऑफ द डे वॉज टेंडर. ऑल्दो हिज मदर वॉज टेंडर टू वार्ड्स हिम एंड गिविंग हिम हिज फिंगर टू होल्ड, सेड, "Look, child, what is before you?" His mother did so because she wanted to divert his attention from the toys. बच्चे को जैसे हम कई बार कह देते हैं, बच्चा कोई चीज़ के लिए जिद करता है तो हम कहते हैं ना कि देखो इधर क्या है। उसी तरीके से उसकी माँ ने क्या कहा, बच्चे व्हाट इज बिफोर यू, देखो तुम्हारे सामने क्या है। तो इट वॉज फ्लावरिंग मस्टार्ड फील्ड, आफ्टर दैट दे एंटर्ड ए फ्लावरिंग मस्टार्ड फील्ड, सरसों का खेत। और व्हाट काइंड ऑफ फ्लावर्स दे वर, पेल लाइक मेल्टिंग गोल्ड एज इट स्वेप्ट अक्रॉस माइल्स एंड माइल्स ऑफ इवन लैंड। इट वॉज ए फील्ड ऑफ इवन लैंड एंड इट वॉज सेपरेट माइल्स एंड माइल्स ऑफ द डिस्टेंस, मीलों मीलों फैला हुआ था सरसों का खेत। तो व्हाट डिड द बॉय एंड हिज पेरेंट्स सी देयर, ए ग्रुप ऑफ ड्रैगन फ्लाइज वर बसलिंग अबाउट ऑन देयर गाउडी पर्पल विंग्स इंटरसेप्टिंग द फ्लाइट ऑफ ए लॉन ब्लैक बी और बटरफ्लाई इन सर्च ऑफ स्वीटनेस फ्रॉम द फ्लावर्स। ही सा ए ग्रुप ऑफ ड्रैगन फ्लाइज एंड दे वर फ्लाइंग हियर एंड देयर एंड दे वर फ्लाइंग विद ए लॉन ब्लैक बी और बटरफ्लाई इन सर्च विच वर इन सर्च ऑफ स्वीटनेस फ्रॉम द फ्लावर्स। ऑल ऑफ द इंसेक्ट्स वर इन सर्च ऑफ स्वीटनेस ऑफ फ्लावर्स। द चाइल्ड फॉलोड देम इन द एयर विद हिज गेज, ही गेज देम, गेज मीन्स लुक्ड अटेंटिवली, निहारना, ध्यान से देखना। टिल वन ऑफ देम वुड स्टिल इट्स विंग्स एंड रेस्ट एंड ही वुड ट्राई टू कैच इट। द बॉय गेज्ड द फ्लाइज एंड ही ऑल्सो ट्राई टू कैच वन ऑफ द फ्लाइज, बट इट वुड गो फ्लटरिंग फ्लैपिंग अप इन टू द एयर। फ्लटरिंग एंड फ्लैपिंग बोथ आर वर्ब्स। वेन एन इंसेक्ट फ्लाइज इट समटाइम्स इट फ्लटर समटाइम इट फ्लैप्स, दैट इज वाई बोथ द वर्ड्स आर वर्ब्स, फ्लटरिंग एंड फ्लैपिंग। When he had almost caught it in his hands, then his mother gave a cautionary call, call of caution, चेतावनी की आवाज। क्या कहा, Come child, come on to the footpath, we have to walk down on the footpath now, hurry up. He ran towards his parents gaily and walked abreast of them for a while, being, however, soon left behind, attracted by the little insects and worms along the footpath that were teeming out from their hiding places to enjoy the sunshine. What did the boy do when they were walking along the footpath? The boy was gazing towards the insects that were trying to fly outside and they were trying to enjoy the sunshine. धूप का आनंद ले रहे थे कीड़े मकोड़े और बच्चा उनकी तरफ देख रहा था। कम चाइल्ड कम, हिज पेरेंट्स कॉल्ड फ्रॉम द शेड ऑफ ए ग्रू, ग्रो ए पैच ऑफ ग्रीन ट्रीज इज कॉल्ड ग्रो, कुंज। हिज पेरेंट्स कॉल्ड फ्रॉम द शेड ऑफ ए ग्रो वेयर दे हैड सीटेड देमसेल्व्स ऑन द एज ऑफ द वेल, ही रैन टुवर्ड्स देम। देयर वॉज ए ग्रो, कुंज था एंड हिज पेरेंट्स वर वेटिंग देयर, देयर वॉज ए वेल ऑल्सो एंड द पेरेंट्स कॉल्ड द चाइल्ड। A shower of young flower fell upon the child as he entered the grove. What happened as he entered the grove? A shower, bochar, a shower of fresh flowers, young flowers, fell upon the child as he entered the grove, and forgetting his parents, he began to gather the raining petals in his hands. The child began to collect the petals. पंखुड़ियों को इकट्ठा करना शुरू कर दिया बच्चे ने. As naturally the little babies, little children do. But lo, he heard the cooing of doves and ran towards his parents shouting. Meanwhile, क्या सुना उसने? Cooing of doves. Doves is a bird. Bee and dove की कहानी सुनिए ना, कॉमेडी, हुगी जिसको कहते हैं, उसका उसके बोलने की आवाज़ सुनी. Cooing of doves and ran towards his parents shouting, the dove. The raining petals dropped from his forgotten hands. And as he ran towards the dove, the petals fell from his hands, little hands. Come, child, come, they called to the child who had now gone running in the wild capers round the banyan tree, and gathering him up, they took the narrow winding footpath which led to the fair through the mustard fields. They called to the child who had now gone running in the wild capers round the banyan tree, and gathering him up, मतलब taking him up with them, उस बच्चे को अपने साथ लेते हुए, they began to walk on the narrow winding footpath, घुमावदार रास्ता, उस पर चलना शुरू कर दिया, which led to the fair through the mustard fields. The narrow footpath led towards the fair. वो रास्ता सकड़ा मेले की तरफ जाता था, through the mustard field, सरसों के खेत में से. As they neared the village, the child could see many other footpaths full of oranges converging to the whirlpool of the fair, and felt at once repelled and fascinated by the confusion in the world as he was entering. Now, in the fair, the atmosphere had changed. There were new kinds of shops. As they neared the village, the child could see many other footpaths full of throngs. It means as they entered the fair, there were many footpaths, but all the footpaths were leading to the fair. And throng means crowd, and crowd of people was coming towards the fair from any footpath, from every footpath, converging the whirlpool of the fair. And all the people were mingling, converging means mingling, मिल रहे थे, कहाँ मिल रहे थे? In the whirlpool of the fair, मानी उस मेले की भीड़ में मिल रहे थे. And felt at once repelled and fascinated by the confusion of the world as he was entering. And the boy, as the writer says, that he was entering the new world. It was a kind of new world for the boy. So what did the boy see in the fair? We shall read in the next paragraph. A sweetmeat seller hawked gulab jamun, rasgulla, barfi, jalebi. The sweet meat seller was selling these sweets at the corner of the entrance, and a crowd passed round his counter at the footpath of an architecture of many colored sweets. And there was a great crowd around his counter. And there were many colored sweets in that shop, in that counter, you see, decorated with leaves of silver and gourds. And all the sweets were decorated with the many kinds of leaves, as we see in many shops. The child stared open-eyed and his mouth watered for the barfi that was his favorite sweet. What was the favorite sweet of the boy? Barfi. And seeing barfi, his mouth watered. "I want that barfi," he slowly murmured, badbadaya. But he half knew, as he begged, that his plea would not be heeded. Heeded means paid attention, dhyan dena. It means he knew very well that his parents would not accept his request, because his parents would say he was greedy. The answer was well known to him. He knew very well that his parents would say that he was a greedy boy. So, without waiting for an answer, he moved on. Because he pressed his desires, apni ichchhaon ka daman kiya aur aage chala gaya. In the next part, a flower seller hawked. Hawk means shouted loud. Hawker se hawk banaye. Hawk se hi hawker banaye. A garland of gulmohar. It means the hawker was selling garland of gulmohar, and he was shouting loudly in the fair. The child seemed irresistibly drawn. Means he was very much attracted. He wanted to buy the garland. He went towards the basket where the flowers lay heaped and half murmured. He went to the heaps of the flowers. Dairiyan, heaps kya hoti hain? Dairiyan. Aur wahan kya badbadaya? "I want that garland." But he well knew his parents would refuse to buy him those flowers, because they would say that they were cheap. क्या करेगा लेके? These are cheap flowers. So, without waiting for an answer, he moved on. Next day, a man stood holding a pole with yellow, red, green and purple balloons flying from it. जैसे we see balloon sellers in the fair, देखते हैं हम लोग. तो here a balloon seller was selling multicolored balloons which were flying on a pole. The child was simply carried away by the rainbow glory of their silken. Carried away is a phrasal verb, means attracted. The child was simply carried away by the rainbow glory of their silken colors. Means he was attracted towards their glory, because they had rainbow colors, multicolors, and he was filled with an overwhelming desire to possess them all. He had a great desire. He wanted to buy them all, the balloons. But he well knew his parents would never buy him the balloons, because they would say he was too old to play with such toys. What answer did he expect? कौन से उत्तर की आशा थी कि भाई तू इतना बड़ा हो गया है, इनसे खेलने के लायक है क्या, बैलून खेलने वाला है क्या अभी। सो ही वॉक डाउन फर्दर, आगे चल पड़ा। एंड इन द नेक्स्ट अपार्टमेंट, इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट, ए स्नेक चार्मर स्टूड प्लेइंग ए फ्लूट ऑन ए स्नेक विच कॉइल्ड इटसेल्फ इन ए बास्केट। ही सॉ ए स्नेक चार्मर, व्हाट वाज ही डूइंग एट दैट टाइम। ही स्टूड प्लेइंग ए फ्लूट टू ए स्नेक विच कॉइल्ड इटसेल्फ इन ए बास्केट। द स्नेक कॉइल्ड इटसेल्फ इन द बास्केट एंड द स्नेक चार्मर वॉज प्लेइंग ए फ्लूट, इट्स हेड रेज्ड इन ए ग्रेसफुल बेंड लाइक द नेक ऑफ ए स्वान। उसका सर फन सांप का जो था उसकी क्या आकार था, लाइक द नेक ऑफ ए स्वान, हंस की आकृति की तरह से उठाया हुआ था। विच द म्यूजिक स्टोल इन टू इट्स इनविजिबल ईयर्स लाइक द जेंटल रिपलिंग ऑफ एन इनविजिबल वाटरफॉल। व्हाइल द म्यूजिक स्टॉल इन टू द इनविजिबल ईयर्स लाइक द जेंटल रिपलिंग ऑफ एन इनविजिबल वाटरफॉल। जब म्यूजिक उसके कानों में, सांप के कान क्या थे, इनविजिबल थे, जब म्यूजिक उसके कानों में गूंज रहा था, कैसे गूंज रहा था, लाइक द जेंटल रिपलिंग ऑफ एन इनविजिबल वाटरफॉल, एक अदृश्य झरने की आवाज़ की तरह उस फ्लूट की आवाज़ उसके कानों में जा रही थी या गूंज रही थी। द चाइल्ड वेंट टू वार्ड द स्नेक चार्मर बट नोइंग हिज पेरेंट्स हैड फॉरबिडन हिम टू हियर सच कॉर्स म्यूजिक एज द स्नेक चार्मर प्लेड ही प्रोसीडेड फर्दर। He also knew very well that his parents would say that it is a kind of course music and you must not listen such kind of music. He knew very well that his father would answer like this, and that is why he moved further. Preceded means moved further. There was a roundabout in full swing. Roundabout झूला. अब now he came to the part of the fair where a roundabout was in full swing. झूला जो था वो पूरी गति पर था, गोल झूला. What did he saw there? क्या देखा उसने? Men, women and children carried away in whirling motion, shrieked and cried with dizzy laughter. जैसा कि हम देखते हैं झूले पर, when men, women, children takes a joy ride, they shout in joy. खुशी से चिल्लाते रहते हैं. The child watched them intentionally and then he made a bold request. I want to go on the roundabout, please, father, mother. He requested his parents that he wanted to take a joy ride on the merry-go-round. There was no reply. He turned to look at his parents. They were not there ahead of him. He turned to look on either side. They were not there. He looked behind. There was no sign of them. Here, around the merry-go-round, in the crowd, unfortunately, he missed his parents. He lost his parents. Here, the story takes a new turn. कहानी नया मोड़ ले लेती है यहाँ. Here,